Thank you. Hello. Yeah, in the show, I'm presenting a video called Une Noix, a Walnut. It's one of the first video works I made 10 years ago. And I had started a series of these very short films after childhood memories or everyday life events and very mundane things. And I wanted to write scripts from these memories, and that's what I did with Une Noix. Actually, it's very simple. I don't know if you all saw it yet, but it's a little girl singing a song and her grandmother is recording and she's trying to help her. And all the time she's interrupting the song and the little girl gets really pissed off and she says, "Stop it," and things like that. And I first wrote the script and then I had to find actors. I really wanted to work with professional actors because for me it was important that the film didn't look like something amateur or, you know, made at home with friends, people laughing in front of the camera. I really wanted to be serious with people. And so I looked for an actress. I saw her in a film and I found her address through another person, and the little girl was a friend's daughter. And they had to learn the text before. And the first time they met was at home when we were supposed to shoot the film. So it was very bizarre because the little girl was so comfortable and the actress was really, I think, intimidated by her. And I guess we resumed 10 or 12 times and that was it. So it was like 2 hours work maybe. And we shot in my place. It was at the time I was living in a studio in the center of Paris. It was really small. So nothing spectacular really. And I made a series of these kind of short films like this one. We are going to watch it. With one or two characters, and always after a short scripts I had written before, and actors were supposed to learn the text, and sometimes it was like this, a monologue, so very frontal. And so let me maybe show you this one. It's called Jocelyne.
On a dîné au restaurant. Il a voulu me raccompagner, c'est comme ça que je l'ai ramené chez moi. On s'est assis au bord du lit. Il a commencé à m'embrasser. Je me suis penchée pour éteindre la lampe. Il s'est mis à retirer ses vêtements. Je me suis retournée pour faire pareil. On s'est chacun glissé sous le drap. Il a recommencé à m'embrasser. En faisant bouger sa langue dans tous les sens, j'arrivais plus à fermer la bouche. Il avait une grosse langue qu'il faisait tourner très vite. Je ne pouvais plus bouger. Tout en m'embrassant, il s'est mis à me pétrir un sein. Il effectuait des mouvements rotatifs réguliers avec une seule main. Au bout d'un moment, il a laissé le sein gauche pour le droit et s'est mis à malaxer. Il avait l'air d'y prendre beaucoup de plaisir. Ensuite, il a mis sa main entre mes cuisses et s'est mis à frotter vigoureusement de haut en bas. Voyant que je faisais la grimace, il s'est dit que c'était agréable et s'est mis à agiter son index avec frénésie. J'ai ressenti des tiraillements. Ensuite, il s'est allongé sur moi et s'est mis à faire des va-et-vient de plus en plus rapides. C'était un rythme mécanique. Il avait l'air totalement absorbé. Il poussait des sortes de grognements à une fréquence d'environ 1 par seconde. Je ne sais plus combien de temps ça a pris. Il s'est mis à grogner de plus en plus fort. Tout à coup, il a rugi. Il est resté là, comme ça. Il transpirait énormément. Il m'embrassait sur la bouche en se retirant. Il s'allongeait à côté de moi. Tout à coup, j'ai entendu qu'il ronflait.
So, yeah, the idea was, of course, to take all these little stories, memories, everyday life things, and to turn them into something absurd, comic, sometimes cruel. And so I guess all this series is a kind of a list of all the situations where we are not really telling important things, but just trying to be together in a social way, like when people ask, so how are you today, and things like that. And I made a lot of videos with these kind of situations. For example, a guy coming back from holidays and telling two or three times exactly the same things to different persons. Oh yeah, the weather was nice and blah, blah, blah. Just also because sometimes I myself were through these situations and I found it so, found them so ridiculous, but at the same time, I guess it's always like this, and so I wanted to make fun of this, but not only fun, like something we all share. And so, and about the simplicity of the frame and the shot, I wanted to have a single shot of film because the dialogues or monologues were supposed to last 2 minutes. There weren't really stories, or it were just moments like this. So I guess it was the best way to make the film, not having effects or moving a camera, things like that. Just, you know, steady frame and just one or two characters, or three sometimes, around the table. A lot of them are around the table. And after this, I started to work slightly differently. But for example, for this film, Jocelyne, I had asked the actress to, as an indication, a play indication, imagine that you are in a police station and that you are giving a report of what happened to you. And because I wanted something slightly shifted between the text, the story, which is really pathetic, and something really sober, a little detached of the content. And so that was the purpose of this film, for example. I don't know if you have any questions, or maybe the best is to ask them in front of the work, une noix. So, you're welcome.